Today I saw the same old crowd I knew before. When they asked me what had happened, I tried to tell them.
Thanks to Calvary,
I don't come here anymore.
Thanks to Calvary,
I am not the man that I used to be.
Thanks to Calvary,
things are different.
He took my place.
boast of anything I've ever seen or done. How could I dare to claim as mine the victories God has won? Where would I be had God not drawn me safely to this place? I'm here to say I'm nothing but a sinner saved by grace.
I'm just a
I'm gonna leave. when I see the sunrise in the morning, when I feel the wind blow across my face, when I all part of God's amazing grace.
And I believe there's a place called heaven. And I believe in a place called
day my mama went to heaven.
Yeah.
I held her hand as she closed her eyes to sleep, and I felt the power of 10,000 angels take her soul.
Thank you for joining with us tonight at Tabernacle Baptist Church through the web. Thankful for technology these days. Amen. And thankful for good help to get things working correctly. So hopefully we've got most of our things behind us on the bug issues. And this thing will work like it's supposed to tonight. I do want you to continue to pray for many that are sick as things is going on around our country. Several preachers that are in need of prayer, their families, missionaries around the world. So do lift them up. God knows each one of those. Remember our local prayer request, Miss Nikki, and the Lord would touch and help her. And then our folks just went through bereavement here recently. Do not forget to pray for them. Pray for the family right up the road here that lost a loved one in the fire the other night here on Lippard Farm Road. So be much in prayer. Lift up, folks. Many things to pray about, and I hope that you're taking these days to spend a little more time in prayer, and we sure all need to. I know I need to spend more time in prayer and at the throne of the Lord. We've got a mighty God, a powerful God, a strong God, a loving God, one that has called and commissioned us to come to Him in prayer. So I am grateful that we have that privilege to go to the Lord in prayer. Well, let me borrow your ears for a few moments tonight. I want you to go with me to the book of 2 Timothy, 2 Timothy, chapter number 3. Now, I know you're familiar with this passage if you've been around church very much at all in these days. You've heard many messages in the latter years out of this passage, but I'm going to go a little step further, so stay with me. Don't get bored on me yet, because I want to share some things with us tonight that I believe the Lord has laid in our heart. In 2 Timothy chapter number 3, verse number 1, the Bible says, "This know also, that in the last days perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying the power thereof. From such turn away. For this sort are they which crept into houses and led captive silly women, laden with sin, led away with divers lust, ever learning, never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Now, as Jannes and Jambres withstood Moses, so do these also resist the truth, men of corrupt minds, reprobate concerning the faith. But they shall proceed no further, for their folly shall be manifested unto all men, as theirs also was. But thou hast fully known my doctrine, manner of life, purpose, faith, long-suffering, charity, patience, persecutions, afflictions, which came unto me at Antioch, at Iconium, at Lystra, what persecutions I endured. But out of them all the Lord delivered me. Yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them, that from a child thou hast known the holy scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instructions in righteousness, that the man of God may be thoroughly furnished, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works." Chapter 4, he goes on, he says, "I charge thee therefore, because of all of this," Paul saying to young Timothy, I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables. But watch thou in all things, endure affliction, do the work of evangelists, make full proof of thy ministry. Would you pray with me? Our Father, in the name of Jesus, I bow before you tonight. I'm asking you, Lord, that you'd move in a special way. So we try to share this thy word with the folks that's tuned in with us tonight. I pray, Lord, that you would anoint me afresh and anew. Forgive me of my sin. Cleanse me of anything and all things that I be guilty of that would hinder you from using me to the fullest of your ability through me tonight. I pray, O God, be with the sick, the afflicted, many across the land needs a special touch from heaven. I pray, O God, you touch them. Brother Joe Hendricks's mother there and others that's going through things. I pray for the families tonight that are in bereavement, those that are near to me and my family that lost loved one yesterday. I pray that God, you'll touch them and help that family, give them the grace that they need in these hours. Then, Lord, for our sick of our church, Lord, we pray that you'd touch and help there, especially Miss Nikki, Brother Chad, Miss Anita. I pray that God should touch them in your special way. Help us all, Lord, that in these days to do thy perfect will. Give wisdom to our leaders, our president, others that are in leadership, even our governor, local authorities. God bless them. Give them wisdom. Give them understanding. Protect them, I pray, our law enforcement, our EMS, our doctors, our nurses. I pray, O God, put a hedge of protection about them. Let them not be inflicted with this virus, and let them not be afflicted by those folks that's out there that means them harm. I pray that you'd help them. In Jesus' precious name, we do humbly pray. Save the lost, we ask also. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to look here just for a little bit this evening in the book of Timothy, 2 Timothy chapter 3. I want to dwell just a few moments here tonight on these passages of Scripture. As I've said, we've known these passages for years. We've heard many messages preached for years. We've preached about the perilous times that they're going to come. And we've talked about in the last days, the things that will come to pass in the last days. I believe with all my heart, with the Scriptures before us, that we're in the last days. I believe that we're not far from the Lord Jesus Christ himself stepping out on a cloud tonight and calling the church home. He could do that before I get done. There's nothing that's hindering the Lord Jesus Christ from coming and getting his children. If you're not saved, that should be a scary thing for you, because you'll be left here for the Antichrist. You'll be left here to go through much worse things than you've ever dreamed of or ever experienced. You'll go through the tribulation time that spoke of there in Revelation. And it talks about all the horrible things that folks will endure during those days. It'll get to the place they'll cry out for the rocks to fall on them. They'll beg God to let them die, but God will not give them space of death. So I pray to you tonight, please, if you're not saved, ask the Lord Jesus Christ into your heart before it's everlasting too late. Now, I want to look at this a little bit tonight, not on the thought of the perilous times will come, or the last days will come, or living in the last days, any of those different titles that we've heard. And I'm not looking lightly on them in any way, shape, or form. But I want to share with us tonight just a little bit about this, picking up in verse number 14. As a church today, I think we need to focus on continuing our course. Verse 14 says, but continue thou in the things which thou hast learned. And I want to preach on that thought just a little bit for tonight, on continuing our course. I think that with wisdom that God has given us, verse 14 tells us about our wisdom that we've obtained. I think we've got some comprehension of things that God has given us there. He's learned us. There are many today that live and act as if they are unlearned. They live a lifestyle as if they don't know nothing about Bible truths and Bible principles and the laws or the requirements of God. They live that way. But God knows, and they know that they've been taught much better than they are living. There's a lot of folks living way beyond, way below rather, the standard of living that they know they should be living. May the God of heaven help them to get back where they need to be if they've been saved by the grace of God. There's a few folks around, I'm sure, that as it says there, they're in the form of godliness, but they're denying the power thereof. There's a lot of folks around that's played church these years. They've been in and out of a church building. They may even been through a baptism. They may even have their name on the roll, but they've never bowed their heart and their mind to God. They've never got on their face before the Lord, ask Him to forgive them of their sins and save them by His marvelous grace. They've never put faith in God. May God grab their heart and they'll surrender unto Him that He might save them before this thing is eternally too late. Now tonight I want us to think about our wisdom in continuing our course. We have a comprehensive, we've got some Bible learning. Hey, listen, you know what God's going to hold me accountable for? What I know and what I could know. Now, I say it like that because of this. There's a lot more things in this Bible that I should know that I ain't studied like I ought to. Maybe you could say amen to that. Maybe you too have been around the Word of God and you should know more than you do. Maybe you should have studied more than you have studied. Hey, listen, our comprehensive of the Word of God, we ought to have more knowledge. Listen, we've got more Bibles, we've got more books and commentaries, we've got more outlines to look to, devotionals to look to, than anybody before has ever had. May God help us to use what comprehension He has given to us. But he also says they're not just talking about what they had learned, but he also talks about them being assured. I want to talk to you a minute about being the confirmation of our wisdom. See, it takes troubles, it takes trials for us to go through to bring a confirmation in our heart what we truly believe. You've got to sit down and go through some debates. You've got to study your Bible and debate your Bible. I'm not talking about getting ugly and arguing in the wrong way, but when you sit down and study and debate what you think you believe, you find out real quick what you really do believe. I've noticed in studying behind some false teachers, reading some false articles of books and so on, I found out what I do believe because I've read those things and it didn't sit right in my spirit. The Holy Ghost of God grieved me with that, and I know that was not truth. My son was in a church many years ago. I've used this illustration many times. He hadn't been saved but just a little while. A fellow got to reading out of a wrong version, one of those that they had corrected and thought they'd made right and all that. Anyway, he wasn't but 6 years old. And that old preacher went to preaching and got to quoting and reading the Bible. What he said was the Bible. My little old boy looked up at me and said, "Daddy, that ain't the Bible, is it?" Hey, listen, if a six-year-old boy just got saved not long before that, I know the difference by the Holy Ghost letting him know that wasn't the Word of God. Hey, listen, what about us? We ought to know better than that, amen? Hey, I'm telling you, we've got some comprehension in our hearts that we're going to have to give an account for. And there's the confirmation of that. I'll tell you this about the confirming of things in your heart. It takes a long night of doubt, a long night of struggle, to get down to where you find out for sure what you know you really believe. I'm telling you, God gives us wisdom and gives us assurance of things in those dark hours, in those dark nights, in those troubles and trials that we go through. We'll find out what we really believe. Amen. There's the comprehension and there's the confirmation. But then also I want you to notice what he closes verse 14 out with. He says, "Of whom thou hast learned." I'm thankful for my chancellor. That's a big word for this little country boy. But I found out that's the head honcho in the university. That's the leader at the university, one of the counselors or chancellors. C-H-A-N-C-E-L-L-O-R. Chancellor, if I say that correct. And he's the head daddy rabbit at the university. And he's the one that's in charge. He's the one that's supposed to know it all. He's the one that's guiding everything that goes on in the learning of that university. So when you go to thinking about that, man, I'm telling you, I'm thankful for my chancellor, how that's taught me in the scriptures. God's used a lot of men and a lot of women through the years to teach me things of the Word of God. But I'm glad He's the one that's directing it. I'm glad He's the overseer. I'm glad He's the one that's brought the assurance or the confirmation unto my heart that that's a Bible truth and that's what God wants out of it. Amen. John 16:13 says, "Howbeit, when He, the Spirit of truth, is come, He will guide you in all truth, for He shall not speak of Himself." I'm glad, thank God, I got the Holy Ghost as my chancellor in my heart to confirm unto me those things that I've learned. He tells us in 1 John chapter 2, verse 27, "But the anointing which ye have received of Him abideth in you, and ye need not any man teach you." That just tells us we got the Holy Ghost. He's inside of us. He's the one teaching us. He's the one that helps guide us. When somebody speaks what they say is truth, He's the one inside to give you that assurance, that confirmation that that's the truth. Amen. So I'm glad that in continuing our course, God has given us wisdom. We have comprehension of the Word of God, what we need to do. We've got confirmation of what the Word of God is, what we need to be doing. And we've got a chancellor that'll teach us and help us in this. Second thing I want to mention tonight is verse 15. He talks about that from a child thou hast known the Holy Scriptures, and has made and which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith in which is in Christ Jesus. So I'm thankful that you can get in Christ Jesus through salvation of the Lord Himself. Amen. I'm glad that I'm part of the family of God tonight. But I want to think about this tonight. I want to think about our walk. He talked about that childhood. We've taught from the Scriptures. We've learned the Scriptures from a child. And from a child, we've been given wisdom. Now, not everybody's had that privilege. But I don't know of a time in my life when I ain't been around an old-fashioned preacher and around the Scriptures. I had a grandma sit down and tell us Bible stories and read the Bible to us. And we'd get together at her house and sit around and sing old hymns of faith. And we couldn't sing on note. We didn't know every key we were supposed to hit. But we had a good time in Jesus. And I'll tell you what, Jesus likes it. Amen. And He shows up when people sing and praise Him. So I'm thankful that I've had the raising that I've had. I had old grandma that raised me up. I had a mom and a dad that taught me as a young feller. And I had a good old uncle, a good old leather lung, old-fashioned Baptist preacher that preached to me all my young days. Thank God for that. Amen. And I appreciate that as a child. A lot of folks ain't had that, but a lot of you other folks have. You've been around church since you was a youngin. You know better than some things. God's given you a lot of learning through the Scriptures as a child. But I'm thankful that as a young child, I got to know the Lord personally. I didn't just know about church. I just didn't know about the churchy stuff. I didn't just put on this little robe of religion and look like somebody that was churchy. I'm glad I got saved by the Holy Ghost working in my heart as a young lad, 7.5 years old, Crossroad Baptist Church on the Miller Farm Road. Amen. Good old timey preacher was a preaching, and I was enjoying that and loving every bit of it. And, you know, I fell in love with preaching. I like preaching. I tell you, I get disturbed or I get nervous or I get a little upset. You know what I can go to helps me? I don't have to go down yonder to the little old store on the side of Center Street and get me some kind of liquid out of that place to make me get calm and settle down. I tell you what helps me, good old-fashioned Holy Ghost preaching. Amen. I like preaching. See, God put that in me. As a newborn babe desires the sincere milk of the Word, hey, listen, a child of God desires the Word of God. Amen. I'm glad as a child I learned to walk with the Lord. That word child there began to make me think about it. That's where you begun. You get saved by the grace of God. You're a newborn babe in Jesus. Amen. And you begin your walk with Christ. How about you get to walk with Christ? Amos tells us that can ask us a question. Can two walk together except they be agreed? And he's teaching us that, hey, you're going to have to walk with the Lord. If you want to walk with the Lord, you're going to have to walk with the Lord in His way, in His word, in His time. You got to be in agreement with the Lord. Amen. I agree I'm a sinner. I agree He's a Savior. I agree I need Him and can do nothing without Him. I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. But I'm thankful that I can walk with Him because I'm agreeing with Him. Amen. He's always right. Say amen to that right there. Our walk. He talks about verse 15 and 17. Verse 17, he says that the man of God may be thoroughly furnished, may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. God didn't save me to sit down. God didn't save me just to sit around in peace and not ever do anything. God saved me for a work. God's got something for all of us to do. That's what I'm talking about tonight on continuing our course. We need to continue our course. I know we're in different days. We all know that. Things is different. Our work's different. Our workplace is different. Where we come and go, all these things are different. But what I'm saying to us tonight, even in perilous times, we ought to continue our course. Paul says, verse 1, chapter 4, I charge thee therefore, because of all of this, young Timothy, I charge you, go ahead and preach. Be instant in season, out of season. Amen. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering. I want you to encourage folk to keep going on. Amen. So we got a work to do. We got a work to do. You know what our work is? It's to continue. Paul's exhorting young Timothy to continue to work. When you look at Revelation chapter number 2, verse 10, it says, fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison that you may be tried. And you shall have tribulation 10 days, but be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. God's got rewards for us if we'll continue. He's not much on those that are slackers, those that are slothful. He made much mention of those in the Proverbs, talked to us about those things there. But he likes that person that'll be faithful. Be faithful in all things. He said he that's faithful in the least of things will be great in other things. He that's faithful in the small things, he'll make him ruler over great things. God's about being faithful. May we in these days not get slack because we can't come to the house of God. We don't get to sit down on our pews and do our normal routine. That doesn't mean we quit on God. That doesn't mean we back up on God. That doesn't mean, hey, that we take a vacation on God. That means we get more busy. Amen. And there's ways that we can be busy. Let me say this to you. There's several things that God has commissioned us to do. We're to continue our praise for the Lord. Psalm 150 tells us that everything that had breath, let it praise the Lord. You still got breath? You ought to praise the Lord. Amen. You got much to praise the Lord for these days. Hey, listen, if you got health tonight, you got much to praise the Lord for. You got a family about you, you got much to praise the Lord for. You got an old-fashioned King James Bible, you got much to praise the Lord for. Hey, you got a preacher that loves you, that's trying to stay faithful and feeds you and encourage you in these days. You got much to be thankful for. Hey, we ought to be praising the Lord. We ought to praise Him for our salvation. We ought to praise Him for an opportunity to serve Him. Hey, we ought to praise Him for the hope and the promise of the second coming. We know He's coming again. Amen. But we ought to also persuade the lost. Even in these times and the way things are set up these days, we still got the opportunity to talk to lost folk. You know, we can reach back, grab one of them things there, you know, and put it up to our ear. Hey, how you doing over there? Yeah, I just been praying for you. Do that, though. I just been praying for you. I just want to know, do you really know the Lord? Are you saved? Do you know you're going to go to heaven? Hey, listen, we got phones we can call folks on. We can write letters. We can send out gospel tracts through the mail. We can do things just like we're doing tonight through Facebook. We got all kinds of ways of persuading the lost. God help us in these days to persuade the lost. Our praising the Lord will be a big part of persuading the lost. If they can see we got something that's real enough in us, that as we go through troubles and trials and tribulations, as we go through these things that sets us back and brings fear to everybody else, as we go through them, if we can still praise the Lord, give Him honor and glory, hey, that'll make much difference in those that are lost. You know what? I'm still thankful to God that I got what I got today. I was able to get up. I was able to come over here to church and study and get some other things done today. Hey, I'm thankful for what God's done for me, aren't you? Praise Him a little bit, will you? And persuade the lost to come to know Him as their Lord and Savior. I want to thank you for joining us on the broadcast tonight. If you don't know the Lord, I'll be here around the church for a little while. You can call us here. I'll talk to you by the way of the phone, 704-871-1251. You give us a ring. If I miss it, I'll call you back. You leave a number, I'll get you called back in the near future and talk to you as soon as we can. Hey, listen, we want to see you get saved. You're going through troubles and just need somebody to pray. I'll be glad to pray with you. Try to help you. Try to encourage you in any way we can. Hey, listen, Jesus loves you more than anybody else ever could. And He's for you. All things work together for good of them love God, and them called according to His purpose. Hey, listen, He's working all things for us in His favor. Amen. It's God's will to bless us and help us in these days. Thank you again for tuning into our broadcast tonight. May the Lord be a helper to you, and may God bless you. Father, thank you for the time. Pray you'll use it for your glory. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
You been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in His grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood? In the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood? Savior's side, are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Do you rest each moment in the crucified? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood? In the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Stained with sin, and be washed in the blood of the Lamb. There's a fountain flowing for the soul unclean. Oh, be washed in the blood of the Lamb. Are you washed in the blood? In the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood?
Find a friend so faithful.